Hello everybody, welcome back. Simslife here with another tutorial. And in this video, I am going to show you how to export your sim into Blender for posing. And I'm going to show you how to get SimRipper and how to use it. So the first thing you're going to want to do is download SimRipper. And you will find it under, you'll find it in MadaSims. I will leave the link also in the description. And so you want to download the first program, not the second one, just the first one, because this is just the resource and stuff. So you're going to want to click on that and download it. You will find it in your downloads folder or wherever you might download your stuff. And then you're going to want to go ahead and extract it. So I'm going to go ahead and extract it right here, open the folder, and then I'm just going to go ahead and just pull it out and put it on my desktop. The next thing you're going to want to do, and I forgot to mention that you will need Sims 4 Studio to be able to get the rig for Blender. So to do that, you're going to want to go to Animation, Clip Pack, and then save it wherever you want. I'm going to save it under Blender Rigs. This I'm going to title anything, it doesn't matter. This is just a package file that I'm not keeping because I'm only doing this to get the rig. So go ahead and save that. And then you're going to want to go to Clips. I'm going to start with a male because it's the first one that I will be exporting. Go ahead and name this whatever. Make sure it's a blank clip. And then export, and I'm going to go ahead and save that also in my rigs. I'm going to name this male and then save. Okay, so now I got the rig. So go into your game, The Sims 4, and start a new save and put in the sims that you want to take out of your game. You know, make sure that they're set and they're dressed the way you want them to look in Blender. And a little word of advice too, if you're going to be using them to do poses with, I would highly recommend male and female putting nails, nail polish on them. It will come in handy for later. You'll know where the back of the hand is when you're posing. So that way, if you mess up the fingers, a lot easier to fix, I promise. So what you're going to want to do is place them on any lot, it doesn't matter, and then save your game. Okay, so now it's time to open up the Sims 4 Ripper. So when you open up the folder, you have these two programs right here. Make sure you click on the application. It might take a minute to load. Once you open it, just go to select. So when it pulls up your saves, what you can do is go by date modified, and it will put the last save that you saved on up at the top. So you can just click the very first one and click open. And now it's going to give you a list of every sim that is in that world. And it does go in alphabetical order by last name. Okay, so you're gonna go ahead and click on it. It might take a minute to load up. So there he is. And you don't have to worry about any of these. I never have. Here where it says outfit, just say you accidentally saved them in the wrong outfit. You can click here and put them back into the outfit here that you want to export them in. And then you're going to go here to save as DAE. And then you can select the folder that you want to save them in and then save. Okay, so here is the DAE. And then you're going to get like a diffuse, normal map, and a specular. Okay, so now double click on the male rig that we exported from Sims 4 Studio. So you can open them up in Blender, hit 5 on your keypad, and then under where it says rig, hit the plus sign so you can drop down these. We're gonna delete everything except where it says pose and the armature data. So you're just going on click, right click, delete. Click, right click, and delete. We're gonna do this for all of them. Okay, so all you'll have left are these black dots. Then go to File, Import, and it's going to be the first one, the DAE, and it says Collada DAE. Click on that. Click on this, the DAE file that you want to import, and then come over here to import. Okay, so now he's in here. And he's the second one right here, the very bottom one. So we're gonna do this drop down menu here for the second rig, and here you see him. So you're gonna wanna left click and drag it to the very top rig. And it says set parent to. We're gonna choose object. So now he's up here. So now that he's on this rig, we can go ahead and delete the one that we had imported. So click on the sim again. Go down to modifier. It's the wrench. Go down to object and choose rig. And now he's attached to the rig. So now when we click on the rig, he's ready to pose. Here's where you see the nails. So for the future, when you mess it up, you know exactly where, because sometimes it's very hard to see where the back of the hand is. And what I'm going to do next is I'm going to go to file and save as, so that way I don't override the sim that, or the rig that I pulled out of Sims 4 Studio, because it's always good to have a backup. And then I'm just going to name this after the sim I imported. And it's going to go into my Blender rigs. And then I'm going to save Blender file. And then I can close out of there. And there he is. And then he's ready for the next time. And then you will do that individually for every sim that you want to import. I would do them individually for posing. Anyways, guys, that's it for this one. If this was helpful at all, don't forget to leave it a like and subscribe, because I will probably do more videos like this in the future. Take care, guys. Bye.